Siema, z tej strony Przekosa i tym razem trochę inaczej, bo jestem na koncercie Eda Sheerana. Jestem właśnie pod Narodowym. Jeżeli wszystko będzie na czas, to za 20 minut wychodzi Ed, także zaraz szybko wchodzimy. No i widzimy się tam. Jeżeli chcecie więcej takich relacji z koncertów, to wbijajcie na IG i TikToka Przekosa i zostawiajcie suba z dzwoneczkiem.
Ale to jest mocne.
Thank you. Well, I'm going to play some songs that hopefully you know. And if you don't, it's going to be an awkward 2 hours. This is a song from our second album.
Oh, I'm a mess right inside out. Searching for a sweet surrender. This is not the end. I can't work.
Basically at the end it's deleted and it won't be the same tomorrow. The way that it works is you press record like that and press play and it plays back and you can loop over it like
we'll be right back.
I play this next song. This next song I wrote when I was 18 years old. And I played it at every gig since then. And all the gigs I played in the early days, no one came to. You can just play to empty rooms. And as it's got bigger and bigger, it is obviously, there's been a trajectory, and I can understand the trajectory, but when I play this song in front of massive crowds like this, I am taken back to the time where I wrote it, when I was playing these venues. More so tonight, because we're in Warsaw, in Poland, and the place that I wrote this song was in, a place called Guildford, and I had two Polish housemates who were here tonight, and they... I don't know if they can know that this song was written next door to them, but Ellie and Mattia, this one's for you. Everyone else, please sing.
And bring the shows in home.
Let's give this one a go. If you guys want energy, this is where we grab the energy at.
Collaborating, writing
songs for and with people. And every now and then, a song that I write goes off and becomes this kind of like huge global mega hit. And everyone always says to me, well, why didn't you keep that one? Why didn't you keep that song? And I always say, you can always write another one. There's a Stevie Wonder quote where he's asked what his best song is, and he says, well, I haven't written it yet. I love that way of thinking about songwriting, because there's always a better song around the corner. There's always the next one, the next one, the next one. So this song I'm going to play now, I wrote originally for Divide. And what happened is I like a drink, and I'd been drinking quite heavily, and it got to about 4 o'clock in the morning. I checked my emails and had an email from this guy's manager. He said, have you got any songs for this guy's project? And I was like, and anyway, I forgot about it. He recorded it. It ended up being his, I don't know if it's quite his biggest song, exactly one of them. But I wrote it on the school bus. States. It goes like this. For all the times that you made my bread, for all the clothes you get in.
I don't wanna, we can't have this moment.
last sort of 11 years of my career where my songs have been like out and about, people listen to them on the radio, you know, they got more popular, I've had more and more people come up to me and say that they use my songs in like their special life moments, you know, whether it's like the first dance of a wedding or like a funeral or like the birth of a child or like all of these things, it's sort of like, it's very overwhelming because it's using a song that, and it just immortalizes it for life. I can stop making music tomorrow, these songs sort of have all these memories all around the world about sort of collecting the different people. And I didn't really realize how massive and cool it was until I sort of had some of these life moments myself. You know, I've had two daughters in the past 2 years, got married, and you know, the song that I used for my first dance, the song that was playing when my first daughter was born, and the song that was playing when my second daughter was born, will be ingrained in my head for eternity. And they're such special songs for me. So the fact that like people in the stadium tonight have stories for my songs, like really, really, really touches me. And I just want to say I really appreciate like you guys having connections and memories with these tunes. Really good. This is a song that is my favourite song I've written, and I know that everyone in here tonight has some story about it.
I found love for me. Darling, just now, follow my lead. Thank you.
screen. It was meant to be up, but it's not up. So bear with us. But we'll have a sing song with this song. Are you guys energetic? You feel good?
Thank you.
Już po, moi drodzy, idę sobie właśnie mostem Poniatowskiego. Było naprawdę zajebiście, koncert trwał równe 2 godziny, naprawdę długo. Nie mam pojęcia, o co chodziło z tymi opadającymi jakby telebimami, bo było to zajebiste i pierwszy raz coś takiego widziałem, że wyświetlały się różne rzeczy i jednocześnie było widać Eda, także super. Naprawdę zajebisty gość, jak wyciągał czasami. Nigdy nie byłem na koncercie w jednym miejscu, na jednym artyście, gdzie było więcej ludzi. Mój największy koncert wcześniej, chociaż wiecie, że dużo koncertów było, była Beyoncé i Jay-Z, taki solowy, też na Narodowym, ale nie było wtedy tyle osób. Zabrakło mi tylko, żeby na końcu dał Icy Fire, ale może dlatego, że go tak nie słucham, to nie znam wytłumaczenia, dlaczego tego nie zagrał, pewnie jest jakieś dobre. Jedna rzecz, jaką zauważyłem, dużo osób narzeka, że na Narodowym jest strasznie chuj głośnienie. Na początku miałem takie, kurde, to prawda, nic nie rozumiałem, ale potem mam wrażenie, że nasze ucho się przyzwyczaja do tego i zacząłem wszystko rozumieć po paru piosenkach. Nie sądzę, że nagle się coś poprawiło, tylko po prostu słuch się zaadaptował, więc ciekawa sprawa, jakie możliwości ma ludzki organizm. Jeżeli wam się podobało, to zostawcie suba z dzwoneczkiem, wbijajcie na IG i TikToka Przekosa, gdzie więcej materiału. Elo!